every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace. Good morning to everyone. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair. And as always, we are thankful and grateful to the Lord that he has blessed us with a brand new day, another day that we can choose to honor him by praising him and thanking him, adhering to his word, appreciating his grace, his mercy, his provision, his kindness, his love, his guidance, all of those things. God blesses us with every single day. As a matter of fact, Lamentations chapter number 3, verse 23 says that the mercies of God are renewed every morning, every morning. And so right now, those of you that are watching us live this morning, right now, if you can see me and or hear me, you have renewed mercy that God has extended to you and I today. And what a privilege and what a joy and what a blessing really it is to have his grace and his mercy extended to us. For the next several days, we will look at a passage of scripture. We were ending our service on yesterday, and we had another powerful time in the house of God here at Greater Faith Bible Tabernacle in Buffalo, New York. And what a wonderful presence we felt and experienced on yesterday. We had communion. We welcomed new members into the church. We had one baptism. The co-founder of our church, Dr. Antoinette Halton Singleton, showed up, and along with her daughter, majority leader, Elder Leah Pope, was there. And we just had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful time. Our elders, our clergy were in their vestments on yesterday. So it was a beautiful, beautiful day. And we're grateful that God sanctioned that day with his presence. But for the next several days, we'll be in Isaiah. This is a scripture that I read at the end of the service. I think they were preparing for baptism, and this verse of scripture dropped in my heart for someone. And I read it. I read it on yesterday, but I didn't do much with it. And so I want to spend some time looking at Isaiah chapter number 40, verse 28 through 31. And for the next several days, we will look at different aspects of this passage of scripture. In Isaiah 40, verse 28, the Bible says, "Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He fainteth not." He does not faint. He does not faint. That's what I want us to focus on this morning. For this particular fresh start, you know, for our fresh focus this morning, even though we were created in the image of God and after his likeness, the differences between creator and creature, that is the difference between us and God, are the characteristics that make him God. Yeah, we were created in his image after his likeness, according to the book of Genesis and the Genesis creation narrative. But one of the other things that we are understanding, I should say, in this fresh focus is that we were created in his image after his likeness, but we are not him. And the difference between what he created, that's us, and the creator, that's him, are the characteristics that make him God. And today, as we step into this brand new day, I want to remind us that the God that we serve does not faint. He does not get tired, and he does not get worn out. And for us, we take courage as we take appreciation in that, we can take our tests that might be wearing us out, causing us to faint, causing us to lose heart, which is another translation of the word faint. We can take our tests to Him, because our tests and what they do to us and how it affects us has not affected God the same way. The same way that a trial may be wearing you and I out, it does not wear Him out. The same way a situation may anger you or anger me, it does not anger Him. And the difference between us and Him are the characteristics that make Him God. And so today, as we step into a brand new week, a brand new day, a work day for some, a day of living and running errands for others, this is the day that the Lord has made. And as we appreciate this day, let us be reminded of the fact that we're not like Him, and we can take what bothers us, what troubles us, what wears us out, we can take those things to the Lord, knowing that it won't wear Him out. It won't tire Him out. He doesn't get weary. He does not faint. And so be encouraged as we step into this brand new day, knowing that whatever is affecting you, it's not affecting Him the same way. Trust and rest in Him. God bless you, and God willing, I'll see you in the morning.
God, this-